Hey everyone, it's Louise, and I'm back for my last pour of the year. 2021 is almost gone. Got 11 more hours to go, Pacific Coast time. So what I'm gonna do today is I'm gonna continue where I left off the other day with my tiles. I'm going to do a deconstructed bloom on the black, and I have Colorplace Onyx Black and Semi-Gloss with about 5% of that GAC 800. And I got the same lineup I have the other day with those tiles that worked out so nicely. So I'm going to go ahead and get started here. So I don't know if anybody's got any plans for tonight. I know for us, we're going to be going to an escape room. I have never done that before. We're going with two other couples, somewhere up in the LA area. And I don't know, it's supposed to be like an hour and a half or so hopefully we'll get out. We'll see. But it should be a lot of fun. You know, it's worth trying something newer once in a while. Okay, I'm being really stingy here, come on. I gotta learn that when you're doing the larger pieces here, you've gotta put a lot more paint down. It's always a learning curve going back to a canvas. If you remember on the last time I did this, with the tile that I really liked, I had another bump of blue right before the last color, teal. So that's what I'm gonna do again. I'm gonna see if I can make something as really cool as I had the last time. End the year off on a good note. So that was my Modern Masters blue, and now I've got my Golden and Amsterdam pearl combined with a little bit of Amsterdam Titanium White here. And like I've mentioned, I put some of the Titanium White in here to make the white show up a little more. So I'm gonna see, I'm really curious how this is going to work on this larger canvas, because there's going to be a lot of negative space in here, just as the nature of the deconstructed bloom. So I'm kind of curious how it's going to work. All right, my Golden's QNAG, which is easier to say for me than quinacridone nickel azo gold, but that's what this is. I'll tell you what, if you just looked at this thing on the store shelf, this color in the bottle, you'd think, ooh. But I don't know, it seems to be magical. At least in my experience. And I remember the first time I broke down and bought some gold, and I thought, oh my God, it costs so much. But I think, you know what, it's worth it. So after the nag, I go back to the blue for a little dollop more. And then my homemade teal. It's just a random gathering of various colors, mostly goldens, that I had laying around extra. But I just didn't want to have several open paints of similar colors. Might as well put something together. Okay, so that's that. Now, my white cell activator. I gotta remember to put more down because this is a larger canvas. And that's not what I wanted to do right there. We'll see what happens. At least my black came out good. All right, so I'm gonna start it up by a little low and cool, get it moving, and then high. very different than the tile. Okay, let's just go to the next one. So I put it on the spinner today so I have an easier way of turning things around. I'm not sure if it's helping me or not. Especially since it wants to just move. Okay, I'll just stop you from moving right now. There we go. Okay, here we go. Number two. Number two. Different animal with the black base, I'll tell you. Okay. That's my gold. Got blue next. And I was worried about that white cell activator, that errant drop, but it seems like it didn't really have an impact as far as I can tell. I have yet to perfect how to scoop the cell activator out of the little cup, not have an errant drips around. Oh, there's not enough white in there. I'm going to add a little more white this time. Trouble is the white, as I've learned, it is a dense paint. So the whatever that goes into making the paint itself is heavier than most other, than all the other paints as far as I know. And so the tendency for the white is to sink. Then back to my little bump of blue. Which I like how that's working out. This Modern Masters Venetian blue is just beautiful. Okay. And okay, let's see if I can get this in the right spot. Right in the middle. Okay, that'll work. Okay. This to me is always the most nerve-wracking part, is getting the cell activator down. My heart like flutters. I wonder what my heartbeat is right now. Because if there's anything that can go wrong, it's that. Okay, I'm gonna move this out of the way. And now here we go. Low to get it going, cool. And I always hold the handle, the cord, because I've had times where I've put the cord in the paint, which is not fun. Way that's reacting. All right. Last one. See, a lot more color on this one. I like it better. All right, last one. Oh, I got something in here. My heck. It's like a, I don't think I got it. Here it is, a little streamer. Oh, here's another one. Where in the world is this coming from? Okay, last one down. I'm gonna put that, let's slide this one over here a little bit more. Heartbeat is going crazy right now. It's like, this is, to me, this whole painting process is so exhilarating. Sometimes I feel very calm, and some days it's just like pitter patter with the heartbeat, and this is one of those days. Hopefully that's a good sign. So I started my day out today like I normally do, with about a 4 mile walk. It's like my, ever since I retired and I went to the doctor back in January, and they told me I was weighed what I weighed, I said, oh boy, I need to do something about that. So I started walking every day, and it made me feel better, but I didn't really notice any loss of weight until over the summer. My husband and I went on this little joint weight loss program through my old company, and basically eliminated carbs and sugars and things. And it was mostly fruits and vegetables. You can still have protein, but you were limited, you know, no crackers, no sweets, no sugary drinks. And I'll tell you what, I started losing weight, and I lost about 30 pounds, 35 pounds. And anybody that would look at me would think, oh, you can't afford to lose that. But for me, it was a lot of weight for me. But I'll tell you what, I feel so much better now. Oh my gosh. I'm back to my high school weight, if you can believe it. My high school weight. So that's sweet. Feel so much better going into the new year. Feeling good. Probably get another walk in this evening before we do the escape room. I'm a little nervous about that because I've never done one of those before, so I'm a little worried I'm gonna look like a nincompoop trying to solve. But you know, I was always interested in being a detective. I went to West Point and I became a military police officer. So I was always interested in solving things, but never did a escape room before, so this is gonna be new. You know, I've been saying all this time that I'm not very gabby, but I guess, you know what? Once you turn on a videotape and you start talking, it just kind of starts coming out. Because I got tons of stories I can tell, believe me. I got a lot of stories. For a little more of that. Okay, here we go. All right. So, activator. White. Please go in the middle. Pitter patter, pitter patter. Oh, nice. A little extra measure. And that's another thing. I never know exactly how much cell activator to put in there, but you see how that thing is haloing? That's what's supposed to happen. Oh no, I didn't want that to happen. Didn't want that to happen, but we'll see. Maybe on black it's not so bad. All right, low, cool. Okay. There we have it. There we go. Okay. I need to give it a moment. So this can catch up to that one and that one. Meanwhile, let's try to give it a little head start here. Look. Okay. Light first. Okay, I'm gonna go really, really slow. So what you start to see happening is the bloom section gets a little mashy, gets a little mashed, and you need to allow the paint enough time to come back so that the paint just doesn't run over it, the bloom. You want it to stretch and be a little compressed but not mangled. There's my girl, Kira. That's my dog. Okay, bring her back. I'm gonna use the spinner so that I don't take you guys completely off the camera. Here we go. Hold back time. How's that look? Wow, I've never done a black base before on this larger scale. I got another one of those little stringy things over here I need to pull out. I see it. There we go. What else do I have? Looks like I've got something over here too. What is this? I just put a drip of water in there. That is bad. Okay, so what I do for that is I get a little piece of paper towel. Of course, my hands need to be dry. I gotta pull that water out of there. Otherwise, I'll have a real big mess. I just dab it up. Oh my god, I'm putting more in there. Are you kidding me? Okay, off with the gloves. I'm making a mess. Let me finish getting this one. And then let's get the second one. See how it just absorbs it? It's actually pretty cool. You just don't want to have to do it. That's all. But you don't want to leave water on there. You're going to have a defective spot. You get to see me make the mistakes, and hopefully you won't have to. Okay, that's not so bad. All right. So I think that's a wrap of 2021 and the painting. Thanks for joining me. Take care and have a great new year. Bye-bye now.